The eight shots at a wicket we are about to see have the following features. First, you'll see the number of the shot in addition to a caption describing the type of shot being tried and a real-time video demonstration of that shot from a distance. That demonstration will only be seen once within each type of shot we cover. Second, you'll see a close-up overhead still image of the shot to be tried. Third, you'll see a still image looking from the non-plane side of the wicket, focusing on the aim of the mallet as it relates to each upright of the wicket. We feel this view from the non-plane side could have a positive effect on calling the shot accurately. This, of course, will require a second referee if available. Fourth, you'll see the real-time action of the shot from the non-plane side, and then another view nearer the striker. Next, you'll see a still image of the direction the ball took after scoring the wicket. It's what we call the exit direction. And finally, a still image profile of how far that ball traveled. We want you to determine whether exit direction and distance traveled is useful information when judging a shot. We suggest you have a pencil and paper and jot down your judgment based on what you saw in each of the eight shots. You will compare your answers when we see the same eight shots with an added slow motion view in the following section. While you certainly may pause the video and review the shots in this initial viewing, we would prefer that you let the video run and see all eight shots uninterrupted. You'll have plenty of time to replay these whenever you want. We are looking for your instincts here. Here we go. As you can see, the action takes place so quickly, you can't really see what happened as it happens. With regard to sound, any double taps that may have occurred are happening so fast, you can't hear them as distinct sounds. They turn into one longer sound. We're now going to see the same 8 shots with the addition of a slow motion replay.